As time moves on, you know, it's really, really good that we have this community feeling, this big family here in Nuneaton, because the people of Nuneaton and Redworth, they support each other and they support the charities what happen.
Today, 201 years of Gurkha military service to the crowns and celebrating that special bond between our two countries.
Good morning, everyone. Mr. Omkrum, chairman, Gurkha Veteran Association, told me to organize nice, pleasant, and wonderful morning. And that's exactly what I have provided. Thank you. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, last year was 200 years anniversary of Gurkha service to the British Crown. Gurkha soldiers from Nepal and from India have served in the British Army in every conflict, in every part of the world. And we are proud that Gurkha from Nepal are still serving both in Brigade of Gurkhas and throughout the Army. All the ex-servicemen and their families will always be grateful to the people of Nuneaton and Warwickshire for the warm and friendly welcome we have received as we made our new home in this area. It is testimonial to generosity and friendship of the people of Nuneaton that we have been able to build this Gurkha Memorial in the town center close to the war memorial. The ex-Gurkhas in this area decided to ask the local and county authorities for permission to build a memorial in Nepalese style, which is here to celebrate Gurkha 200 anniversary. Not only did we get permission, but we also received significant financial help to add to fundraising locally. I must take this opportunity as Secretary Gurkha Veteran Association Nuneaton Bedwood to give special thank you to everyone who helped with fundraising and to all local businesses who support us so generously. We are very lucky indeed to have such friends as you. Today is the first anniversary of building of the Chautara, so we are taking this opportunity to invite our old and new friends here for the traditional lighting of candle in honor of day. Ladies and gentlemen, without doing any further delay, now I would like to welcome Mr. Om Prakash Gurung, member of the Order of the British Empire. Please, Chairman, come forward and say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rabin. Good morning, Mr. Mayor, Madam Mayoress, Member of Parliament, Mr. Marco Jones, Lieutenant Colonel Flair, Commander Queen's Guard Signal, Brigadier Broad, CVE, Mr. Dennis Harvey, Leader of Nuneaton Better Border Council, and his Managing Director, Alan Franks, Mr. Buzz Stevens, Chairman of Armed Forces Community Covenant, and the Odisha County Council, Inspector Dean Reed, North Odisha Police, Major Tulbahadur Kamsa, Gurkha Major of Queen's Gurkha Signals, and our very special guest, the star of television and proud daughter of Nepal and sister of ours, who raised £3 million in 2 days for relief earthquake victim. Of course, I mean Miss Joanna Lumley, OVA, the fellow of Royal Geographical Society. Other guests, ladies and gentlemen, we the British Gurkha Veteran Association would like to thank you all for coming to this very special event for the Nepalese community in the region. The special thanks are given to all those who have helped us in any way to arrange and hold this 201st anniversary of Gurkha Convent to the British Crown. I must mention of a barrier who have supplied the crowd control barrier free of charge. Anchor Radio, who have loaned us the public address systems without fee. 30 Signals Regiment for loaning the chairs and providing the guard of honor, and Nuneaton Battle Border Councils for their very active cooperation. Of course, there are many other participants in this event. We would not do without standard bearer, buglers, pipers, religious leader, and volunteers. Our youngsters, charming boys and girls, we thank you all for your contribution in helping us remember the sacrifices for our fathers. Thank you.
So thank you very much. Now I invite Miss Joanna Lumley, Officer of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, Fellow of the Royal Geographical Society. Ma'am, could you please come forward and say a few words? Thank you.
Distinguished guests and friends, namaste. And what an honour it is to be here in Nuneaton. It's my very first visit here, and I think that we've arranged a perfect day, the perfect weather. We had a little light rain before, but that was just to keep us on our toes. Now, the thing about today is that it's more important than almost any of us here can really imagine to have a memorial here to the Gurkhas, the veterans, the ones who will never come back again, to have their memory bright here in the very heart of our country. I'm a daughter of Nepal, I'm a daughter of the regiment. I was born in India simply because my father was serving with the Gurkhas. I was brought up in Hong Kong because we traveled with the flag to Hong Kong, and from there to Malaysia where my father was serving. And so I am truly a Didi to all of you. And Nepal runs in my blood. Now here in Nuneaton, you've been the warmest hosts and friends, the most welcoming family to the Gurkhas and the Nepalis who've come to live amongst you. And that is such a proud thing, which is now established in front of us in this absolutely beautiful memorial. The things that we most admire: steadfastness, good humor, friendship, loyalty, bravery, are all manifest in the Gurkha soldier. And this, which has this touching inscription, "Better to die than to be a coward," says exactly what it means to be a Gurkha. We've seen them, these brave hill boys from Nepal, walking sometimes for many days to enlist to serve our country. For that, there are no thanks adequate. You've done something quite extraordinary in raising this money. would say, Darai Danyabad for that. And Sari Ramro. And thank you so much from everybody in Britain, and I think the Nepali community too. Thank you all. Thank you to everybody here today. And I would like to say, Jai Nuneaton and Bedworth. Jai Nepal!
Ma'am, thank you very much for your kind words upon us. Now, I would like to invite His Worship, the Mayor of the Nuneaton and Bedworth, Councillor Barry Longden. Please, sir, come forward and say a few words. Thank you.
I might start to fill up, so you have to excuse me. We've had an extraordinary year, and part of that year has been made a lot richer through our connections with the Nepalese community and the Gurkha veterans. I'm proud to be here today as part of the ceremony. And can I thank you? I can't use the words that Joanna's just used. Can I thank you on behalf of all the British people, all the Gurkhas who died in the name of this country? We are very, very grateful for your sacrifice. And we are very, very grateful for your continued friendship. And I hope there's going to be more Nepalese. I think there's children coming along all the time now, so that's great. And they are such a wonderful people. And yet, they are very mild and meek and polite. But you've got a cookery in the hand, and there's something very different. I've witnessed that. I've served with the Gurkhas. I was captain for a short period with the Gurkha signals. And it was a great honour to me to do that. I've took the jabal off because it was choking me in part, but I've got my regimental flag on, tie on, and I'm proud of that as well. And thank you for your invite today. It's had a nice celebration, and I'm sure when you get over the club, things will start to hot up a little bit. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I would like to invite Commander Queen's Gurkha Signals, Lieutenant Colonel MJ Fares. Sir, could you please go forward and say a few words? Thank you.
Mayor, distinguished guests, Joanna, Roy Donald MP, Marcus James, Saibaru, Dinibahini Haru, sir, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege today to be here representing the serving members of the Brigade of Gurkhas. I'd like to start with a few thank yous I made. Firstly, I'd like to thank the Mayor of Nuneaton and Bedworth for hosting the event today. I know throughout your time as Mayor, you have made a significant contribution to both the serving members and also our veterans. So I thank you very much for your energy and passion and integrating us so well in the local community. Thank you. Secondly, I'd like to thank Joanna for sparing some time today in her very busy schedule. I'd also like to thank her on behalf of the serving members of the Brigade for her continued work with the Gurkha Welfare Trust and the difference it makes to the broader Gurkha family. Thank you. Thirdly, I'd like to thank the British Gurkha Veterans Association for Bedworth and Nuneaton for their sterling work, and in particular OMSAR for making today and the memorial possible. I think it's a real sign to success, the integration of the both veterans and the serving members with such a good turnout today. So OMSAR, on behalf of as your chair role, thank you very much for your stern leadership and efforts. Last year, we the Gurkhas celebrated our 200th year of loyal distinguished service to the Crown. 200 years of service in all its forms, from the early days of the East India Company through to the Indian Army and today with the British Army. Our Gurkha 200 celebrations witnessed the vast array of events, including the high profile public duties at Buckingham Palace, parading through London, and Royal Pageant last year at the Royal Chelsea Hospital, in which Joanna was also a distinguished guest. Given the demands of Gurkha 200s on the service, on the serving brigade, many smaller events felt the squeeze, and therefore it's great that today we continue this recognition beyond our 200th year. I think this memorial is a truly fitting way of celebrating the achievements of Gurkha 200. But it's also a memorial which salutes and remembers the 46 plus thousand Gurkhas, officers and soldiers who have made the ultimate sacrifice in service to the Crown. Thus, the memorial is also a celebration of 200 years service, as well as commemoration to those that have made such selfless commitment. In the Brigade, we say once a Gurkha, always a Gurkha. And therefore I'm truly delighted to see so many veterans of the Gurkhas here today, many with their families. Our veterans have played a critical role in paving the way for the success of today's Brigade. In particular, I'd like to make a special mention to our veterans from the British Gurkha Veterans Association in Nuneaton and Bedworth. The association has been particularly effective at creating an excellent relationship between the serving generation and our veterans. But their relationship has extended to many other military veteran associations, both Royal British Legion, and I see many various today from that association, but also the Gurkha Welfare Trust. Moreover, the association has been successful in forming a deep, strong relationship with the local community, and again, the turnout today reflects the strength of this relationship. We, the serving generation, are exceptionally grateful to our veterans. Our reputation as Gurkhas has been hard earned through bravery, professional excellence, fortitude, and unwavering loyalty, grouped together with our unique Haida and sense of belonging. We, the serving generation, have a responsibility and duty to maintain this reputation. Indeed, our recent success in operations is a testament to this, for our deployment in Afghanistan, Sierra Leone, and Nepal since inauguration of this monument last year. Gurkhas, and particularly the Queen's Gurkha Signals, have been based in Nuneaton since 1993. Over the last two decades, Nuneaton has formed a special part, the heart of the Queen's Gurkha Signals Regiment. It is home of our regimental headquarters. It is where our soldiers formally get welcomed into the regiment, post their training at Catterick. And it's also the home to 250 Gurkha Signals Squadron. But of course, the regiment has broader members of the brigade in its ranks, including the Gurkha Special Pay Service, the Queen's own Gurkha Logistic Regiment. So Nuneaton has half the brigade's cap badges represented here. This strong presence of serving Gurkha soldiers in Nuneaton and Bedworth underlines why this memorial is so important to the serving members. Tomorrow is the first anniversary of the earthquake in Nepal. Indeed, while the last year has been one of celebration through the lens of Gurkha 200, it's also been remembered from the terrible earthquakes and subsequent human tragedy. It's hard to fully comprehend the magnitude of the continued devastation that Nepal receives. Indeed, I returned only from Nepal yesterday, and it's clear that many challenges still exist. But the people of Nepal are resilient and determined. The people of Nepal, Government of Nepal, combined with organisations such as Oxfam and the Gurkha Welfare Scheme, are making progress, but it's hard earned. Lastly, to return to the monument and today's memorial service, we are truly grateful for the Mayor and his team, and to the British Gurkha Veterans Association of Nuneaton and Bedworth for their support in this monument and this event. Collectively, they recognise the loyal service of the Gurkhas to the Crown. They recognise the sacrifice made by Gurkhas, but most importantly, they recognise the special bond that exists between the community of Nuneaton and Bedworth, and both serving and retired members of the brigade. Thank you very much.
So, thank you very much. Now, I invite Member of the Parliament, Mr. Marcus Jones, please. Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lumley, it is a pleasure and an honour for me to be here this morning. In this area, we have now a great affinity with our Gurkha friends, our Nepalese friends who have been with us the best part of 25 years now. We have taken the Nepalese community to our hearts, and they have become an embedded and important part of community life here in Nuneaton. And I am absolutely proud to all our Gurkha friends, my friend. And it's great that we are here today, because this is a fitting memorial, not just to that 25 years that the Gurkhas have been affiliated with the people of Nuneaton. It's a fitting memorial to over 200 years that the Gurkhas have stood side by side with the British Armed Forces across the world, keeping this world safe. And I'm extremely proud of that link, and I'm proud of what this memorial represents. On behalf of the people of Nuneaton, I would like to thank Miss Lumley for coming here today and gracing us with her presence and reinforcing that bond between the people of Nuneaton and the local Gurkha community. We don't just support our Gurkha community here in Nuneaton. I think this country gives great support to Nepal, and quite rightly so. And we live in times where it's often difficult for people like myself to justify giving support to our friends in countries abroad. And this event and the support that the Gurkhas have given to our country shows why we should be supporting people of Nepal and the many challenges that the people of Nepal face and the difficulties that they face compared to the challenges that we have in our country. I would like to thank Mr. Mayor and the Council for the work that they've done in putting this event on. I would like to thank the Gurkha Veterans Association for their hard work, not just here in putting this event on today, but also the hard work that they put in with the Nepalese community, supporting the community at all times and integrating that community into the wider community of Nuneaton. And I would like to thank all of the other people that have come forward to support today's event. The Gurkhas are an extremely important part of our community here in Nuneaton. I regard them as our friends. They are great friends, allies, and are always great supporters of our country. So thank you once again for organising this memorial. Thank you for organising today's event. And let's hope that over the years, this memorial will come to represent that bond and that strength that there are between the communities in this area. Thank you.
So thank you very much. Now I invite Major Nigel Willie-Craig, Secretary of Gurkha British, Gurkha Brigade Association. Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, Joanna Lumley, distinguished quick guests, it is a great privilege for me to come and stand here amongst you, but I represent the President of the Gurkha Brigade Association, Lieutenant General Sir David Bill, and the Gurkha Brigade Association, as part of our family, comprises the serving brigade of Gurkhas, so ably represented here in Nuneaton by the Queen's Gurkha Signals, part of 30 Signal Regiments, and also all the regimental associations, of which we have 8 regimental associations, here largely represented by the Queen's Gurkha Signals Association, as well as elements of all the others. But what I would just like to raise is the synergy between the three strands. Mr. Mayor, we in the Brigade of Gurkhas take great pride in the fact that the Queen's Gurkha Signals Regiment has the freedom to march through your borough. This is a great privilege, and I think it is a reflection of the esteem that the people here in Nuneaton and Bedworth have given to our soldiers in this area. So thank you very much indeed. Secondly, it's our serving brigade, and here we have our chairman, Mr. Om Prakash Gurung, who formed this association some, I think it was in 2006, am I right? 2009. But within that period, within those 6 years, such a lot has happened under his leadership within this community.
we certainly saw the creation of this wonderful memorial to Gurkha service over the past 200 years. And long may that service continue in the future. But that service, which was the memorial which was opened only last year, was tinged with sadness, with the tremendous and terrible earthquake which occurred in Nepal. Yet, on that very day, the Gurkha, British Gurkhas Veterans Association, together with the people of Nuneaton, focused their attention on the devastation that occurred in Nepal and turned to raising funds for Nepal. The third point I would really wish to make is the people of Nuneaton themselves. Because it is the people here, Mr. Mayor, who have supported the serving regiment, the regimental association through the British Gurkhas Veterans Association. You, together with the association, together with the Rotary Club, together with all the school children, raised tremendous funds for the people of Nepal. And I know that the Rotary Club wanted to raise funds to build, only, it sounds small, but 22 earthquake-proof huts in the Republic of Nepal. What a tremendous gesture. And I think what I would like to end by saying, it is this working together, this ability of our veterans living and working in Nuneaton, our serving soldiers, serving here in Nuneaton, and the people of Nuneaton, all getting together, working together, raising funds for Nepal, such a long way away, many of whom have not been there. Now, if that is not some form of integration, I really don't know. And I would like to thank the people of Nuneaton, Mr. Mayor, yourself and the council, the serving brigade, and also and your association for the quite sterling work that you do here. And I think we can take great pride in this memorial. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Now we'll move forward with the Gurkha Collect. The Gurkha Collect will be read out by young Nepalese boy, Master Deadlock Kachwal, age 11. Deadlock.
Legends were told, but when the war started, those legends began to unfold. The army was seen more frequently during times of wars and conflicts. They helped the innocents and were so skilled, even the most notorious enemies they tricked. And when the war was over, the Gurkhas went back home, waiting again until they were again needed. They won the war, so I think it's fair to say that they succeeded.
Now is Nandika Lohorum Roy, age 11. Nandika?
Namaste. I'm Nandika. This is my family. It's called All Careful Approach. We sharpen our blades, we sharpen our knives, head towards battle, and sacrifice our lives. Born to Lake Valley, All Careful Approach. Never to place and by Gurkha side, we are no cowards, we do not hide. Glory to Great Valley, Gurkha's approach. We are loyal, determined, courageous and brave. We fight for those we need to save. Glory to Great Valley, Gurkha's approach. From the village Gurkha, we fought the British for our territory. Glory to Great Valley, Gurkha's approach. Thank you for listening to my poem.
Thank you, Nandi Kandari. Now turn us tribute to the Gurkha soldier, read by Master Thomas Cross, age 12. Thomas.
As I wrote these last words, my thoughts turned to you, all my comrades, the stubborn and indomitable peasants of Nepal. Once more, I hear the laughter with which you greeted every hardship. more I see you in your bivouacs are about to fire. I force march her in the trenches, now shivering with bitter cold, now scorched by a pitiless and burning sun, uncomplaining of endure hunger and thirst, and loot. And at last, your wavering minds disappear in the smoke we have of battle, the bravest of brave, the most generous of the generous, never had country more faithful friends than you.
Let us remember people good and every history of keeping them who have lived and died in the service of my country. This shall grow not old, as we that mark live through, it shall not wear them all the years to come. At the going down of the sun in the morning, we will remember.
Blessings by Gurkha religious leader Pandit Jagannath Kodo.
Congratulations to all who gathered here for the celebration of first anniversary of this Gurkha monument. It is very important for all of us and all the residents of this town of Nuneaton and Bedward. On this occasion, we remember those brave veterans who made a unique Gurkha identity, keeping the motto, better to die than to be a coward. In Nepali, it is Kanta Nunu Handa Varno Bes. We have glorious history of bravery from more than 200 years. I hope this day gives us inspiration and strength to keep our unique Gurkha specialities, and may Goddess Durga bless us and protect us. The blessings are prayers from Durga Saptasati. Om Jnani Namaki Chetamsi Devi Bhagavati Hisa Balada Krishyamohaya Mahamaya Payachati Durge Smrita Harasivi Dimasi Sajantu Swasthe Smrita Mati Mati Vasubham Dadasi Daridra Dukha Bhaya Harinika Tudanya Sarvu Pakara Karanaya Sada Prasita Sarva Mangala Mangale Sivi Sarvartha Sadike Sarane Triambake Gauri Narayani Namostute Saranagata Dinatha Haritrana Parayane Sarvashakti Hare Devi Narayani Namostute Sarvasvarupe Sarveshe Sarvasakti Samadvite Vaibhyastrahino Devi Urge Devi Namostute Rogana Seshana Pahamsi Tushta Rushkatu Kaman Sakalana Vishtan Kamasritanam Navipannaranam Kamasrita Akasrayanam Prayanti Sarva Badha Prasamanam Trailukyasya Kileshari Evameva Tayakaryam Asmadvairi Vinasanam Om Durga Devi Namaha.
Now, the dedication service by Minister of Religion, Reverend Hallel Corner, please.
this memorial stone, which we ask God's continued blessing upon, stands proudly as a fitting tribute to over 201 years of service to the British Army by the Gurkha soldiers. Over 43,000 lost their lives in World War I and World War II, and we honour them today. This memorial stone, which we rededicate, also honours those who have served and those who continue to serve in the Army today. The Gurkhas and their families are an important part of our community today, and we are proud to call them our neighbours and our friends. And we ask God's continued blessing upon you all. Amen.